This is Captain Philip with Airworthy Tours, your guide in the sky. And today we're taking a tour of Iceland's captivating geography. Known as the land of fire and ice, Iceland is full of natural beauty that includes waterfalls, glaciers, volcanoes, black sanded beaches, and more. With that being said, sit back, relax, and enjoy the tour. Some quick basic facts about Iceland's geography. The island of Iceland is located in the Atlantic Ocean, near the Arctic Circle, and in between Greenland and Norway. With an area of approximately 40,000 square miles, or 102,000 square kilometers, Iceland is the 18th largest island in the world, and the second largest island in Europe after Great Britain. The entire island is governed by the Republic of Iceland. Below is Reykjavik, Iceland's capital and largest city. Reykjavik is the most northern capital city in the world. With 364,000 residents, Iceland has the lowest population density in Europe at 9 people per square mile. And 80% of the country is uninhabited. Our first in-depth look will be of Iceland's massive glaciers. A glacier is a large, persistent block of ice. Glaciers usually form on land when snow stays long enough in one place to turn into ice. Over the years, decades, or centuries, the snow is compressed into thick ice masses. In Iceland, there are 269 named glaciers that cover more than 10% of the landmass of the island, with some glaciers dating back to thousands of years. The top three of Europe's largest glaciers are located in Iceland, with Vatnajökull being the largest at 3,100 square miles, or 8,000 square kilometers. It is almost the same size of Puerto Rico. However, these glaciers have been retreating over the past 100 years and are at risk. According to PYH.org, since 1890, the land covered by glaciers has decreased by almost 850 square miles, or 2,200 square kilometers, which is about 18% of their total mass. Experts have warned that Iceland's glaciers are at risk of disappearing entirely by 2,200. Below is a fjord, which is a byproduct of a glacier. A fjord is a long, narrow inlet with steep sides or cliffs. They are formed when a moving or retreating glacier carves out a U-shaped valley. But what separates fjords from other valleys or canyons is that they are connected to the sea, and all the water in the fjord is salt water. There are a total of 109 fjords in Iceland. As glacial ice melts, most of that water heads downstream, creating Iceland's beautiful waterfalls. According to Iceland Travels, there are around 10,000 waterfalls situated on the island. Iceland's climate and geography create the perfect formula for stunning waterfalls. Because Iceland is situated in the North Atlantic, the climate is cold, wet, and windy, meaning there's a lot of rain and snow that falls consistently throughout the year. All that water needs somewhere to go. And the tall mountains in the middle of the country provide the elevation required to get all that melting ice and rainwater to keep moving. Next, let's look at Iceland's volcanoes. There are over 100 volcanoes on the island, 35 which are active. This is due to the island's location along the Mid-Atlantic Ridge, where the North American and European tectonic plates are being pulled apart, causing continuous volcanic activity. On average, Iceland experiences an eruption every 5 years, with the most recent being in March of 2021. Fortunately, they usually occur in the more sparse areas of the island. However, Iceland's worst volcanic eruption occurred in the summer of 1783. The Laki eruption of 1783 lasted 8 months and poured out 14 cubic kilometers of lava, the greatest lava flow witnessed on Earth in the last millennium. The eruption produced so much ash that it blocked the sun, leading to crop failure and the death of livestock. The ensuing famine led to the death of 10,000 people, or about 25% of the island's population. The volcanic haze from the eruption went as far as to Syria. Over the past 500 years, Iceland's volcanoes have produced a third of the total global lava output. However, a major benefit of Iceland's volcanic activity is that it provides an endless supply of geothermal energy. In fact, over 90% of housing in Iceland is heated by natural geothermal heat, which is one of the cheapest and cleanest forms of energy in existence. The abundance of geothermal heated water creates natural spas, with outdoor relaxing and bathing in these nature spas being a favorite activity enjoyed by both locals and visitors. Another byproduct of the geothermal activity are the numerous geysers on the island. There are approximately 20 to 30 geysers in Iceland. And here's a fun fact, the root of the word comes from the Old Norse and Icelandic term of geysa, meaning to gush or to rush forth. And another benefit of Iceland's volcanic activity are the numerous black sanded beaches. The black sediment on these beaches have been formed by boiling hot lava from nearby dormant volcanoes floating across the beach and then cooling and solidifying when hitting the cold water. After this cold hit, the solid lava starts to break apart and form small volcanic rock, which then gradually weathers down further to create smaller pebbles and finally into black sand. However, unlike other volcanic islands with black sand, Iceland's beaches can be very cold and often dangerous for swimming. In 2006, the black sanded beaches were used to film the Clint Eastwood-directed movies of Flags of Our Fathers and Letters from Iwo Jima, to replicate the historic World War II Battle of Iwo Jima that had the same volcanic sand. Iceland is one of the best places in the world to see the Northern Lights, due to its close proximity to the Arctic. The Northern Lights, or Aurora Borealis, occurs when solar wind approaches the Earth. When it meets the Earth's magnetic field, the energy released during these collisions causes a colorful glowing halo around the poles, an aurora. The best times to see the Northern Lights in Iceland are from September to mid-April, and the further you go from the capital and largest city of Reykjavik, the better chance you have of seeing this natural phenomenon.
If you enjoyed today's tour, you can tip your tour guide by hitting the like button. Also, if you'd like to donate to the channel, there will be links for that provided in the description box below. Thank you for flying with Airworthy Tours, and we look forward to seeing you on our next flight.